Okay, there is, I use, I think it's a free version is available for you guys. Let me capture, guys, capture here. So I can make a capture with this guy actually. Okay, here. And this is a graph I want to copy. This one. Copy. And then you're going to have your report. Should be.
Can you paste the image? Yeah.
Control
D. Yeah, he created that little image, but yeah. That's what.
Come on.
Okay, snippet too.
So slow. Okay, that is so slow here. So now here, copy and paste it. So you can use. Come on. Yeah, my computer is so slow somehow. I think it's a problem actually. So this is what you can generate your figure for the report. So I just give some idea. If you have the different type of the way to do it, that will be fine, but that's usually I use. Okay?
You're saying
like
what you need more than you have later on.
Later on, okay. Yes. Later on, and there's a whole problem, you need to use a similar link. Okay, yes.
You had access toggles, is that within MATLAB code, or can you do that from
a I think MATLAB code is, I didn't do it actually. I usually I do is after you grab this one, I just type the there. But if you use MATLAB code, then it will be okay. So that's the one here. Well, let's go back to here, a little bit of here. So this is, okay, good. So going here, your response will be like this. I want to keep this one, so I'm going to have save to here. So you don't have to select it. So this is openers, right? So I give some stat and check it out. Open. So 1800 goes to 800. That's good. Okay? But there is some load is connected. That means equivalently, that means there is certain condition. And it's not like the output is not like that. If there is some kind of load, then that's not this one. Go to Simulink force. Where is Simulink? There is some disturbance. So load is applied, then you can have equivalently. It's not exactly like this, but some kind of a disturbance. You can add it here. Actually, it should be minus here. Same amount of current, but it will have source. I consider this is a load, okay, simply. Several different ways you can do that, but in this case I give you some help here, or 500 for example. Okay, this is the case you are doing. So you can run this one, then your output will be like this. So because of load, it doesn't reach to here. So it will go to about 1200, something like that, right? So it will go down like that, okay? So if it's a different load, the more is there, sometimes it's a big load, sometimes it's a small load, Every time to make up 1800, what you need to do? You have to compensate here. You have to change, right? You have to change your input, right? So we don't want to do it. Once 1800, no matter what condition it is, I want to maintain the 1800. That's why you do. You configure your control system as closed loop. So I'm going to make a closed loop, okay? So one way you can do closed loop is here, instead of this, here, now another arrow here. Here. For the time being, let's assume there is no load. So it's a zero. Okay? So I'm going to make a closed loop. It means I'm generate power amplifier output based on, not based on input, based on input and output difference. So error signal. So I'm going to have here, this is the input, the output will be this, right? So I'm going to check power amplifier output will be depends on the input-output difference. So input minus output, there is some error, then it will generate some output. Okay, that's what you do. That is a closed loop system. Okay? So let's learn this guy. So closed loop system, learn it. So now, this case is 1800, right? So now what you have here, actually is not 1800. It is 900, something like that, okay? There is a reason why it's 900. You really make this is 1800, then you have to increase. If it's a small error, increase more, that's what I mean, okay? So increase this gain, make it faster, it'll go up there. So example is, let's have this one to make it instead of one, because it's closed loop now, make it 10. So now let's have compare with the input. So let's run this guy. So now look at here. It was very slow going to like this. Now it's very fast. It reached to here. Okay? I can make it faster by increasing 100. For example, I can make 100. Let's make 100. So small error, you still generate. That's what I mean. Now look at here. Right? It's almost max there. It's very fast, similar to actual input. This is an ideal case, not real system is like this, okay? Because you cannot make a 1,000 amp, the 100 amp here. Let's say if it's usually 1 amp, nominal is 1 amp, it's 100 times. Usually it's not, but let's assume we have enough power. So if it's that's 100, that will be like this, okay? So now let's make this 100 here, first of all. 100, okay, let's keep that in mind. Now, what was the problem before? Because there is some load. Then there is error there, right? So now let's apply the same load here. Before is 500, let's go to 500, and run it here. Look at that. Even if there is a load, still maintain, right? That is a good thing about closed loop. It's outside. Even if there is some outside disturbance, you can maintain your the desired output. Okay, that is a good thing about closed loop. Okay? Any questions so far? So I give lots of the terminology here. Disturbance, input signal, output, and error signal, like that, okay? So this is one of the simplest. program is simple. I consider that the simplest system. Yes.
The error signal, is that arrow going into the minus sign there? The first.
Because that's the difference. Because the input, if it's an error, I have 1800. If you have 1700 RPM, then you have to increase your power, right? That's why plus minus.
Okay, so the error term is the negative sign? Or like the difference between the two?
For this case, it's positive. Now, one thing is we call this output feedback through to input right here, right?
Uh-huh.
So we call this feedback system, and we call negative feedback. Uh-huh. If it's a positive feedback, it's unstable. For example, let's make this positive. That means it's going to be unstable. So this positive system always unstable. Look at here. Your output is gone, even for candle simulator. Not this one. Come on. That's so slow. Okay, now go back here. I think I didn't code this guy. Go back here. Okay. Now run this guy. Done. Still have a problem. Because it's unstable. Very unstable. It's a huge one. Okay. I can make a small 41. It's getting smaller. But it's okay. Should be okay this guy. Yeah. But your output is cannot maintain it with this guy. It should be unstable actually. Because of this one. If you make this zero, then probably it's okay here. Yeah. Let's make this one to zero. No disturbance for server. Run this guy. Still stable. That doesn't make sense. Small error, probably now it's unstable here. Look at here. The error is less than one, probably it's going to be stable. Less than one is still stable. But if it's greater than one, it will be diverse. Okay? That's the instability actually. Closed this system always like that. So when you have a closed loop, that is a good thing. But you have to make sure your stability. Okay? So nobody uses actually for positive feedback. Okay, it should be always negative feedback. Negative feedback, as you can see here. Now if you have the 100 here, let's have this one to about 1 second here. Because it's fast now. But now 1 second doesn't go. 2 seconds. Learn it. So you're gonna have like that. Response is fast. So very nice response coming there. That's the closed loop system. Okay, this is the simplest controller. That's gain. And there's some more here. Simplest you can do it. But this is theoretically you can do it. Practically you cannot do this one. So okay. Now let's go to next one.